We continue with vapor pressure of liquid solutions and Raoult's law. Vapor pressure of liquid solutions, solutions in which the solvent is a liquid. Now we did one part of this Raoult's law. We are already done with the Raoult's law for volatile solutes. Now we are doing Raoult's law for non-volatile solutes. This is the vapor pressure of solutions of solids in liquids. The solvent remains the liquid, that is how it is a liquid solution, but this time the solute is a solid. That is why this is known as Raoult's law for non-volatile solutes. Now we have a diagram here. In the first this vessel, we have the pure solvent. As you can see, the number of gaseous molecules above the liquid is greater as compared to this one, in which we have a solute as well as a solvent. This solvent is the liquid and the solute is a non-volatile solute. It is a solid. You can see what is the difference between the two. I have covered both the vessels by bell jars. The difference is that the number of vapor molecules is greater in this case. It is lesser in this case. Why does this happen? Because in the presence of a non-volatile solute, the escaping tendency of even solvent molecules is reduced. Because yahan pe pure solvent hai, yahi solvent yahan itna escape kyun nahi kar raha vapor phase mein. As you can see, solute molecules are occupying the space on the surface. Thus, they reduce the escaping capacity of even khud to non-volatile hai hi. Solvent ki bhi escaping capacity pe effect ho jata hai. Because of which, number of vapors is less. Therefore, it has a direct impact on the vapor pressure. When you add a non-volatile solute to a liquid, its vapor pressure will decrease. How will we study it? We study it quantitatively like this. Now, vapor pressure of the solvent in the solution, we already know by the general definition of Raoult's law that vapor pressure of the solvent is the mole fraction of the solvent in the solution into vapor pressure of the pure solvent. We have done this previously also. But if the solute added is non-volatile and it is a non-electrolyte, it will not contribute to the vapor pressure. Yahan pe jitna vapor pressure hai, you don't see any green spheres in the vapor phase. Jitna bhi vapor pressure hai, that is exerted by solvent molecules only. The solute does not contribute to the vapor pressure. Thus, we can say that vapor pressure of the solution is due to the vapor pressure of solvent only. Right? You will have to pay attention to this whole thing. Kaise hum derive karte hain Raoult's law for non-volatile solutes. Thus, we can say that vapor pressure of the solution is the vapor pressure of the solvent in the solution. Combining 1 and 2, we can write down vapor pressure of the solution is the mole fraction of the solvent in the solution into vapor pressure of the pure solvent. We can write it like this. PS is the vapor pressure of the solution. It is equal to mole fraction of the solvent multiplied by vapor pressure of that pure solvent, P naught. Or we can write PS by P naught is X1. Thus, vapor pressure of the solution in which we have dissolved a non-volatile solute is the mole fraction of the solvent in the solution. It's directly proportional. I don't know how this proportionality sign has gone up here. It's directly proportional to the mole fraction of the solvent in the solution. So that if we plot a graph, it is the same graph, it's just that is diagram mein numbers nahi the. I thought of adding one more. If we plot vapor pressure versus mole fraction of the solvent, vapor pressure of the solution versus mole fraction of the solvent, this is what we get. We get a straight line. This point shows the vapor pressure of the pure solvent. Now, how we reach to our equation of this Raoult's law for non-volatile solutes. Now, let's presume we have a solution which contains N2 moles of the solute, which is non-volatile, dissolved in N1 moles of the solvent. Since solvent is a liquid, it is volatile, right? N2 moles of the solute dissolved in N1 moles of the solvent. Then, mole fraction we have done, mole fraction of the solvent in the solution will be X1 is equal to N1 divided by N1 plus N2. We have done this. We'll substitute this equation, this value of mole fraction in equation 3. This is our equation 3. PS by P naught is equal to X1. X1 ki jagah hum kya likhenge? N1 by N1 plus N2. Subtracting each side from, this is just mathematics, we have to arrive at a certain equation. Subtracting both these sides by 1, we get this. P naught minus Ps divided by P naught is equal to N2 divided by N1 plus N2. Now we changed the whole thing to the mole fraction of the solute. We started with the mole fraction of the solvent, but by doing this step, by subtracting both sides from 1, we reach to the mole fraction of the solute. Now this is the equation of the Raoult's law for a non-volatile solute. Now in this expression, a few things are very important to remember. P naught minus Ps, vapor pressure of the pure solvent minus vapor pressure of the solution, is the lowering of vapor pressure. This expression is known as the lowering of vapor pressure. And the whole thing, P naught minus Ps divided by P naught, is called as the relative lowering of vapor pressure. I keep saying this again and again, every word is important. This much is lowering of vapor pressure. The whole thing is relative lowering of vapor pressure. And this is the mole fraction of the solute in the solution. Hence this expression 4, which is the equation for the Raoult's law in case of non-volatile solutes, the relative lowering of vapor pressure of a solution containing a non-volatile solute is equal to the mole fraction of the solute in the solution. Right? Remember this, mole fraction of the solute. So you have to be very, very smart with this. Sorry, I had to take a pause. Azan ho rahi thi har jagah. And you have to be very, very smart with the mathematics of this whole thing. We start with this equation. Where were we? We start with this equation. Ps by P naught is equal to x1, mole fraction of the solvent. And where do we reach? We reach to the equation in which the whole thing is equal to the mole fraction of the solute. How we reach there, the steps are very, very simple, nothing complicated. You just have to be very smart in understanding this whole thing so that finally you're able to define Raoult's law for a non-volatile solute is this. The relative lowering of vapor pressure of a solution containing a non-volatile solute is equal to the mole fraction of the solute in the solution. Right?